What exactly is evidence?
Evidence is the truth, what actually happened. The number of people who got a certain treatment and had a certain outcome.
Okay, but how is evidence different from what my doctor tells me?
Let's say you're trying to decide whether to take drug A or drug B for a specific disease. An expert or doctor will give you an opinion such as, I recommend you take drug A because it's much better than drug B at curing this problem. Evidence will say, 40% of the patients who took drug A were cured, whereas 80% of the patients who took drug B were cured.
I think I'd like to use evidence, so where do I start?
What question would you like to answer with evidence?
I'd like to know if using my rescue inhaler for my exercise-induced asthma can cause any sort of dependency.
To use evidence, you must first frame a clinical question that matches your unique situation. Let's use the Pico method to formulate your question. P stands for patients like yourself.
Like me?
Right. Patients with the same age, ethnicity, gender, medical history, and diagnosis of exercise-induced asthma. In this case, the P is young, adult, female patients with exercise-induced asthma. I stands for interventions or treatments. What treatments are you interested in or worried about?
I'm worried about using my rescue inhaler regularly.
Okay, so in your case, the intervention would be the regular use of inhalers. C stands for comparison. What do you want to compare the intervention or treatment with?
I'd like to compare people who use rescue inhalers to those who don't use rescue inhalers.
For your question, we will be comparing a rescue inhaler to no rescue inhaler. O stands for outcomes. What outcomes are you interested in learning about? Outcomes can be anything from cure to side effects to relief from symptoms and so on.
I want to know if I would end up needing my inhaler more often because my body's getting used to it, or if somewhere down the road I'm never able to get off them and I need them all the time.
For your case, the outcome of interest is dependency or addiction, a potential side effect of regularly using a rescue inhaler. So using our PICO method, your clinical question is, in young adult female patients with exercise-induced asthma, does using a rescue inhaler regularly increase probability that one then becomes dependent to inhalers compared to similar patients who do not use inhalers?
Sounds good.
Now you're ready to go get the right evidence. Please refer to our evidence numbers video, which will teach you what to look out for. With basic reading and math skills, you can learn to use evidence with your personal physician to make informed decisions for all your healthcare questions.